Greetings, world. We are Anonymous.
This is Dale Pugh, Marketing and Public Relations Director for University Medical Center. This message is being recorded at approximately 5:15 on Friday, September 13th. Tupac Shakur passed away today at University Medical Center at approximately 4:03 p.m. Physicians have listed the cause of death as respiratory failure and cardiopulmonary arrest. Funeral arrangements are pending.
I'm losing my mind. I'm the barrel of my dying. My business level is falling to pieces in my guilt. I pray to the Lord, but he ignores me. Unfortunately, I'm not forgiven. So when you're there, I'm hoping. Choking up marijuana smoke. But then it's dope. It's like a motion poker. I'm falling asleep while I'm in service. When will I die?
This is extreme. You can prove it. You didn't shoot the Archbishop.
I don't think you understand. These boys killed my dog.
Hey, this is the 21st century. You can't go to war with these people. In the end, the law is on.
Earthquake.
No, Captain.
Battle for nations.
We fight! This is where they die! And these shields, boys! Remember this day, Jim. It will be yours the whole time.
Keep your data safe for your peace of mind. Revolution Radio, freedom slips.
Spartans!
You don't need to expect it.
Lay down your weapons!
How dare you?
No, how dare you?
No, no, how dare you?
How dare you?
No, no, my, how dare you?
Persians! Come and get them!
Off radio station on...
Success.
long time. New ideas, different hosts every night, different subjects every night. You never know what's going to happen right here at the Round Table Fight. King Arthur has nothing on us. We're going around and around.
And the dragging me out into the cold when I'm in my pajamas. That was not fun. They seemed pretty shocked by the sarcastic, belligerent, angry teenager that they dragged out of bed that day. I don't know if it's just that I was 19 or that I was a girl, but they didn't expect this. My automatic rounds catch them while they sleeping. Now I'm the last motherfucker. 10,000 angry kids, whoever they are, they scared the shit out of some people those days. They scared the shit out of the powers that be. And that's why this is being investigated. That's why I'm under indictment. That's it. Because between the days of December 6th and December 10th, 10,000 angry people proved to the government that their regulations, their ideas, their view of PayPal, their view of WikiLeaks, their view of the Afghan war and Egypt and Tunisia and Libya, it didn't fucking matter. Their opinion no longer mattered because someone was out on the internet kicking ass.
Yeah, this
go out to C. Lawrence Tucker, Bob Dole, anybody else to feel like they stronger than the Constitution. Freedom of speech, baby. You can't break me, never make
me break the soul. And we're joined by Christopher of the Fleming family, I'm sure, backed by popular demand.
Always.
Yo, yo, yo.
Always. He keeps the bike from falling over. He's our third leg.
Yeah, if you want to put it that way.
Well.
I can't
do a sexual innuendo. Simply means.
I was just thinking about a three-legged dog.
Okay.
Actually.
Lucky.
Yeah, named Lucky.
I'm always left out. I'm like the third wheel.
Well, that'll work, right there. You could be like the sidecar on the motorcycle.
Right. That's
right. Oh, he's the sovereign sidecar. We'll call him the sovereign sidecar.
Okay.
People always are coming up with names for me. What's up with all the names?
Everybody has a name.
Names and labels.
Well, it's like all your barrage of tattoos. You know, like you got all these labels already on you. It's like, why not?
Better than name calling.
Our politicians should have tattoos of all of their lobbyists on them. That's my opinion. What do you guys think?
Maybe just an elephant or a donkey.
I remember seeing
at least some pins.
Yeah, I remember seeing like a picture like where they had Ron Paul, like he didn't have any of them, and, like everyone else was all covered in all these. There's like a picture when Obama and against Ron Paul in 2008. They're like, if they had to wear like all the logos of everyone who sponsored them, and like Ron Paul's like suit was clean, and everyone else's suit was just covered in like all
Ron Paul's, which is military.
stand for freedom of speech, the power of the people, the ability for them to protest against the government, to right wrongs, no censorship, especially online, but also in real life.
Yeah. Actually, the thing about Ron Paul is that he would still have
members throughout society and all strata of it worldwide.
Yeah, we have no leadership.
So
we have
one voice. It's not individual voices. That's why we don't show our faces. That's why we don't give our names. We're speaking as one.
Did anybody bring pizza?
Good time.
Yeah, digital pizza. You're first.
I would love to have Mark, but you know, you push a button and it's not the other way around.
Lose weight. You like your favorite movie star too. You know, all that good stuff is going to be implemented in that thing. So Chris, I heard you had a run-in with the law, as they call them themselves.
I'm always running in with the law.
So since last week, I think that you had your episode that Rectify's talking about, and then did you not go to file some paper to the court, and you had a pack of cigarettes with a whole stack of papers?
Yeah, they.
So you follow through, and that's very diligent.
Yeah, I don't know if we really want to get into that kind of stuff on here, though. But we can talk about the other stuff, but not the other stuff with the lawsuit.
Whatever you want to talk about.
Just because I don't want, because, you know, at some point there's going to be negotiations for settlements, and they're going to be like, oh, we have this recording here of you talking about the case on, you know, and you said this, and then, you know, so I really,
yeah.
I just don't even want to get into that. Like, that whole matter, once it's all done, then it's all done.
Well, just to let everybody know, the round tables.
To declare at this point, like today.
Yeah, a house is my house, and if anyone's living there, you know, we're gonna have problems. So,
I guess that's for the public record, but this is a bad public record because we don't record the roundtables. But I wanted to give our number out because we invite everybody, so we can throw the microphone around the table. 347-688-2902. 347-688-2902. Or Freedom Screen on Skype. And you can join us and have a little chit chat. We'll throw the mic around.
Oh yeah.
Oh yeah.
Anything you want.
But yeah, I have some footage. I just wanted Chris to explain. There was a domestic violence call on him, which is a bunch of bullshit in my opinion to begin with, because I've been involved.
Is that the same thing, or is that something different, Christopher? There's different ones.
I think one of them was from court. When I went into court and I told the judge she was my trustee and she ran out, and then there's another video. Where, you know, one of the neighbors had ended up calling the police or something, you know? So
I have here that I'm going to play eventually after we're done talking about all this is basically going to teach people how to talk to the cops as a sovereign man. Not even talk to them and give statements, but how to ask questions, because you're the master, they are the servant. That's why their name is Sir.
Well, I wasn't even trying to teach people, just get the cops away from
down,
me.
You're poor, man, I know.
Leave me alone, dude. That's it. I'm going to be left alone, man. You know?
Right. I always
but
get called.
You have the right to speak.
I get called negative a lot by my own wife, even, and it's—I don't remember whose show I was hearing it on earlier, but there was a guest on, and he was speaking about how. Oh, it was Roxy Lopez's show, and she had a guest on. He was talking about, you know, you have to be negative and positive. You have to have both in order to have the balance. So whenever someone says, "Oh, you're too positive" or "You're too negative," That really doesn't equate to me, because I seek balance. I don't know, Travis. I called you Travesty. I meant Travesty, Mr. Travesty. Isn't balance important?
You know, I really feel like it is. I mean, things seem like, oh, everything's got to be quote-unquote positive. Everything's got to be love and unicorns and ascension and whatnot. You know, but there's something...